Kedu, kia ora, and good morning. Hello, how's everyone doing today? Eh? Wonderful Sunday, a bit breezy though. Hey, I know it's been a while since I did a plug, but look, I thought maybe I share a little bit of some of the things that I've, I guess if you will, experienced, or maybe something that can help many families out there. But before I get into it, check out my new feature. I've had this fountain for well over 20 years, which has just been sitting there collecting dust. So I thought I'd add it to my feature here in the garden. Check this out. Oh, you know what I'm saying? And you know what? This ball here actually spin. Yeah, check this out. Look at that. Oh, yeah. And the beauty about this is I can sit in my bathtub right here and be able to enjoy it from that angle. You know what I'm saying? So look, and then, I mean, from this angle, right? Check this out. From this angle, this is what my garden looks like. And then when you come into this angle here, you have, of course, the fountain that I've you know, preserved all these years. And then, of course, everything else is practically the same. But one of the things I've actually done for quite a while now is actually propagated a lot of the plants in here, you know, because plants are very expensive these days, you know what I'm saying? So I've been doing a lot of propagation around and basically doing some cutting and, you know, and replanting them in here so that hopefully nature will just take over and do its thing. And that's been happening quite around. But, you know, I can't get into that right now. I promise you one day I'll show you all my garden space and some of the interesting things I have literally done in here. Yeah, but that's for another edition. But today I wish to focus on a very important topic. Yeah, a very, very important topic. Excuses. Yeah, I know you've heard it before, but one of the topics I covered was based on pointing fingers. Yeah, have you noticed how generally people who making excuses generally just go straight into pointing fingers? Yeah, I mean, you see it all the time when you go for meetings and all that jazz, and then somebody makes an excuse, and before you know, they're like, oh no, it's this person's fault, that person's fault, that's why it happened, you know, that day a bird flew over and pooped while it was in the air, and that's why it happened, all that jazz, you know, we come up with all kinds of, sorry, no, that's not, I'm sorry, that's a gross and terrible exaggeration about the bird flying in the air and pooping in the air and all that. Like, I'm just mocking the whole thing, because the kind of excuses I've heard, oh man, it's really bad. You know what I mean? I think the reason why people make excuses, in my opinion, is because they fear consequence. Yeah, they fear consequence. So they'll make an excuse, they'll blame other people, and it just gets worse and worse and worse. It just keeps going down, 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 down. But what I've realized is that when a person owns up, yeah, to what they do, you achieve more, much, much more. And I'll give you an example. 2 weeks ago, a woman decided to enroll their child in my program. But before they did, they asked to speak to me as the founder of Pride Lands, and they wanted to, you know, hear more from me and all that bit and pieces. And she was a very, very lovely woman. She said, look, I've read about you, I've seen your videos, you know, you have a huge endorsement from so many people, you know, through word of mouth and so on and so forth, you know. But, and then she said, what do you think about what people say, you know, some of the negative things people have said about you, you know, over the years? What do you think about that? And I asked her one question before I answered, right? I said, these people, do they have their full name and their faces, you know, when they go on, you know, when they do their finger warrior thing, you know, online, you know, do they, you know, and so on, do they have it online? And she said, not really. I said, Then I said, look, first and foremost, I don't give a damn about what anybody says. I really don't. All I care about is the benefits, what I can do or what I do for this generation. You've seen my videos. You've seen the things I do with these young people. The social development programs, the adventure weekends, the pride escapes, all these incentive initiative, the Pride Initiative, the Help 100, you know, designed to help 100 young people every year. All these things I do for these young people is to benefit them, because I want them to be better. I did not make an excuse about how people speak of me, because I don't give a damn. I really don't. If you look at my history, if you look at what I've achieved for young people, I've helped so many young people, many are adults now, and have a future because I have stood by them. When their community have excluded them, their community have kicked them out, and I kid you not, schools especially, some schools kicking young people out, boom, 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 and say, oh, you know, it's for the well-being of this. What are you talking about? Schools are meant to be an educational institution. How do you educate by kicking a young person out? So some schools are open to working with me because they see a value in what I bring. I have psychologists who work with me, people who have degrees, years and years of degrees and plaques on their walls saying they are high achievers and so on. And some reason they still come to me for answers. I guess what I'm saying is that if you waste a young person's time and then make the excuse afterwards when they fail, then it doesn't matter what excuse you make, you are responsible. Yes, I admit, I've had a couple of young people who've come to my program in the past fail. But I now understand how and why. And every time I learn and I get better and better and better and I save more and more young people, make no excuses. Excuses is a waste of time. When we make excuses, when we start pointing fingers, we waste our young people's time. That's right. That's the biggest factor as a result of why young people fail. We spend so much time as adults pointing fingers and making excuses and not seeing it for what it is. We have young people waiting for us to do everything we can as a community and work together to help them have a better future. But no, some of us, our selfishness gets in the way. Our wounded pride gets in the way. So I said to this woman, I don't give a damn what people say about me. All I care about is what I can do for this generation so that they can grow up to be better, better than you and everybody else out there, including myself. Way better. Stand the test of time. Pass on the legacy I give them to their generations so that they are strong, confident, and can stand the test of time and the challenges that awaits them. That is what I give this generation. And you know what? It's working. When you come to my program, these children have the confidence of men, of a pride of lions. It's amazing. The things they come up with, the activities, the way they see things, it's incredible. I cater for children who are neurotypical and who are neurodiverse. It's a mixed, it's a social integration program designed to include everyone, no exclusion. Ask people out there who know me, they'll tell you. So yes, I'm a proud man. I make no excuses, and I certainly will not point fingers. I don't have time for that. In the end, you know what this woman said? She said, you know what, Moses? I know we haven't met face to face, but I like you. I like you. Please book my child into your program. And she said, I look forward to meeting you in person one day. Parents out there, don't let other people who have failed in their lives stop you from doing what you can for your child right now. Because if you allow them to tell you what to do, that will fail your child and you will be heavily disappointed. Don't allow it. Don't give in. Keep fighting for your children. They are worth it. Have a good day. See you there. Bye.